Today we'll be talking about the Gemini Midheaven with the Sagittarius IC. Hello and welcome or welcome back to my channel. If you don't know me, my name is Nina. I am a Western tropical astrologer who's been studying astrology since 2014 and reading professionally since 2017. To book a reading with me, you can go to ninabastrology.com. But today we are in the final stretch of the Midheaven series since I go from Pisces to Aries. Tackling Gemini Midheaven. Now, this is just a general interpretation of the Gemini Midheaven. There's so much more that can influence your Midheaven, your IC, your chart in general. So, a couple of resources for you. First of all, to understand more about what the Midheaven is, how I like to interpret it along with the IC, you can watch this What is the Midheaven video introducing this series. You can also watch my aspects to the Midheaven video to get more information about how your Midheaven can be uniquely affected. And I'll link some videos on my Party Trick Astrology channel as well that are planets in the 10th house and planets in the 4th house, which will also affect your IC and your Midheaven and the things that they represent. But with the Gemini Midheaven, I think these people are a hoot and a half. I think they're so fun. But one thing that you'll hear a lot about Gemini Midheavens, which is where I hear the most anxiety from clients coming from, is this idea that you won't have a stable, secure job, that you won't have something to really be able to root your feet in. Now, that certainly is one interpretation, but let's analyze exactly where that's coming from and what else might be possible in interpreting the Gemini Midheaven. So I want to start with the Sagittarius IC, actually, because with the IC, it's really where you come from, your roots, the world that your family introduced you to. And that is really what dictates the direction that we decide to move in our lives, the public persona that we decide to take on, the status that we even feel guided to or allowed to strive for. With the Sagittarius IC, this is also a pretty fun placement in a lot of ways. Sagittarius is all about perspective. It's a lot about culture. Oftentimes with the Sagittarius IC, this can be an indication that you come from a very cultural family, or potentially that you come from a family with a very strong belief system, religion, something like that. Because the idea is that with the Sagittarius IC, your family endowed you with an immense amount of perspective. That could be spiritual perspective, this understanding that different belief systems exist, or that different cultures exist, maybe because your family comes from a variety of different cultures or a different culture from what you grew up in. Or simply education could have been a very important thing that your family endowed you with that allowed you to gain a very broad perspective of what is available in the world. In my opinion, it's a really beautiful gift. When you have from the onset of your development this understanding that the world is such a big place with so many different perspectives, you also get endowed in you at your core this idea that the world is full of opportunities and that you have access to these different perspectives, you have access to these different opportunities. Now, of course, a Sagittarius IC is not considered the most intuitive, is not considered the most stable IC. So even though I think that it is such a beautiful gift to, as a Sagittarius IC, be endowed with this perspective and this idea that the world is your oyster and there are so many opportunities around you, what it can do is sort of mess with your sense of rootedness, mess with your sense of security, because You know, Taurus on the IC or Cancer on the IC are more of those intuitive placements in which you sort of can expect things to remain the same and consistent to a certain extent in your family life, in your home life, and in which also there is more attentive emotional nurturing in your family life and your home life. That's maybe not so present with the Sagittarius IC. You know, for instance, if your Sagittarius IC manifests in the way that you come from this very big family with lots of different perspectives to endow you with, through the diversity and the cultural roots of your family, it can be hard to sort of find a consistency in your roots because, oh, I come from this sort of family because they have these sort of roots, but I also come from this sort of family, or I grew up in this sort of way, which was different from what my family grew up in. And yes, you're endowed with a lot of different perspectives, and in that way, this sense that there are so many opportunities for you because you see the vastness of the world beyond a limited perspective. But I guess there can be more of a difficulty to just plant yourself. Now, what does that have to do with how we interpret the Gemini midheaven? So I think that's all really relevant to bring up in response to this fear that Gemini midheavens sometimes have of not being able to have a stable, consistent career or status. And that's because when you're endowed with this gift of perspective and you're aware of all of the opportunities that exist in the world, it can be hard for you to choose just one path to go down. And because of that, your interests and your passion can guide you one way for a little bit, but inevitably you start thinking there are more opportunities out there. There are more pies to stick my finger in. Okay, that was kind of gross, but I just kind of came up with that because of the Gemini term, a finger in every pie, you know? A Sagittarius IC is inherently passionate. And in turn, a Gemini midheaven is inherently curious. And so the role that you want to step into is of someone who can make use of their passion by pursuing whatever sparks their curiosity. And that, of course, can translate into having somewhat of an inconsistent career. Now, it's not like something like a Pluto on the midheaven where there's sometimes an indication of tumbling out of a position of power or just like having the rug pulled out from under you in some way as it relates to your status, public persona. It's more a sort of restlessness within you of wanting to pursue everything that you can pursue. So if you have a sort of unstable career, if you take some twists and turns and go in different directions in what you pursue in your career, it's going to be out of your own choice. It's going to be out of your own restlessness. But to reframe it a little bit from, you know, inconsistent career, not having that stability, there is actually an opportunity there where a Gemini midheaven indicates that you have so much savvy around so many different things. And it's actually a gift that you're able to dip your toes into so many different career opportunities because of your savvy and your curiosity around so many different things. Like I said, also, the Sagittarius IC is indicative of having education be something really important, a value that your family endowed you with. And because Gemini is a Mercury-ruled sign, oftentimes the career or the public persona that you step into is something that hinges off of your intellect, hinges off of your savvy. And oftentimes you can see Gemini midheavens in career fields that are considered pretty intellectual, especially information gathering career fields whether that's something to do with, I don't know, data collection, research, or if you take the communication aspect of Gemini that is really prevalent, someone who is in public speaking or whose public persona is quite social. But especially because the natural ascendant for Gemini midheaven is Virgo, there can be a reputation that Gemini midheaven step into of being nerdy. And that even translates much better in adulthood than in your potentially Scorpio third house experience, where that's something admirable and interesting about you, that you know so much about so many things and are able to make use of that knowledge. And like I said, there are different ways to interpret the Gemini midheaven that doesn't just mean an unstable career. It can just mean that in your career field, you juggle a lot of different things. Maybe if you're a researcher, you wouldn't be the exact type of researcher who is an expert in, like Brené Brown is a researcher, she's an expert in shame and vulnerability. That's sort of the research that she goes into. I don't actually know Brené Brown's chart.
Sidebar from me and my cat. I actually just looked up Brené Brown's chart, and she's a Virgo midheaven with Pluto, Uranus, and her moon in her 10th house. So if that is not the most like researcher on vulnerability and human emotions for sociological purposes, I don't know what is.
But it could be that a Gemini midheaven researcher doesn't specialize in any one certain field of research, but maybe does a little bit of human data collecting for sort of more sociological purposes, or data collection to better understand how to build infrastructures, or I don't know, I'm not an expert in these things, but you see what I mean. Like, your public persona, which often translates into your status in your career, your position, may be something that has a lot of opportunity to branch out and do different things or explore new territory within the same label. This is definitely a very social midheaven. It can be that your public persona is of someone who is very sociable, who is very involved in interacting with other people, and who is just very socially oriented. And like I mentioned, the Virgo ascendant is the natural ascendant of a Gemini midheaven, bar, you know, interceptions that can affect the order of the houses. And while there are a lot of things that the Virgo rising can have in common with the Gemini midheaven, such as this intellectual nature, this savvy that they can draw upon, the real big difference is that sociability that is very present in the Gemini midheaven and not so much in the Virgo rising. So that would be kind of the thing that might throw people off of a Gemini midheaven Virgo rising, is that you see this person every day who might be a Virgo rising who is shy and to themselves, but you can tell that they're intellectual and have some savvy, and then suddenly online or in a public speaking event, they are so talkative, so social, and all of those things that you wouldn't necessarily expect them to be just interacting with their rising. Another thing is that surprisingly, the Gemini midheaven might have a more introverted experience in the Sagittarius IC part of their life. Because even though Sagittarius is so exuberant and passionate and all of these things, you would think that the natural default for Sagittarius IC is also to be exuberant and vibrant and passionate and all of those things. There is an element to that Sagittarius IC that still feels very small in the grand scheme of their own family, if they have a big family, or if they have a family that, whilst endowing them with passion and the sense of perspective and opportunity, actually kind of takes center stage in their home life, to where the Sagittarius IC may feel sort of small. And that's a way that they might gain perspective, is like, wow, I'm actually very small and individual in the grand scheme of my whole family, or in comparison to the way that my family members express themselves. That's not always the case, as Sagittarius I see might also feel very exuberant and passionate around their family, and even especially around their family. But the reason I bring up that potential interpretation is that, like I mentioned, Sagittarius is not the most nurturing sign. And so on the IC, it's not the most nurturing family experience necessarily, emotionally nurturing. Like, your family can definitely nurture your intelligence, can nurture your curiosity, can nurture your passion, even your indignation. But there's not a lot of attention paid to the individual that gives them a strong sense of rootedness in themselves, which can again influence the way that they behave around their family, thinking, oh, I'm just one small, lonely part in this big, exuberant family. But then, in contrast to that Sagittarius I see that might feel the tendency to want to be less involved, take up less space in their home life, a Gemini midheaven wants to be very involved in their career or wherever their public persona is showing up. Again, it's that curiosity. And to kind of like harp on more the opposition between these two signs, Sagittarius and Gemini, Sagittarius is a bit more detached because it has this sense of perspective. It has this sense of, you know, they're quite small in the grand scheme of things. They might be more, even chill is a good way to put it. Chill as in less involved, more go with the flow. On the other hand, Gemini is like, let me get my hands dirty. Let me get in this. Let me interact. And so if in your family life, you're feeling like you're constantly always needing to go with the flow, or like you don't have a lot of say in the way that things operate, in the life that you build for yourself, in your outward public persona, in your career, you might want to have a more hands-on approach in that area of your life. Which is especially why I think when some Gemini midheavens hear that they might have an inconsistent experience in their career, it kind of freaks them out a bit, because they're thinking in that Pluto sense of like, I could lose my job or have to switch gears in a dramatic way, and that would mean that they are sensing that they might have an experience in which they can't be as involved as they would like to be. And I will just say that if we're just taking the Gemini midheaven on its own, no aspects or planets that might be influencing it, there's nothing to say that you won't be involved with the direction that your life heads in. And if there is any switch up or inconsistency in your career or future, in your goals, we can even say, it's going to be at your own hands. It's going to be because you are wanting to switch gears. It's going to be at the helm of your own restlessness, of your own curiosity, of your own desire to branch out. So I hope that quells some of your anxieties, if you had any. I hope that sheds some light on your Gemini midheaven, Sagittarius I see. I would love to hear if this resonated with you, how it resonated for you. Again, if you want to know more about your midheaven, your IC, check out those other two midheaven videos, like Aspects to the Midheaven, and as well as my Party Trick Astrology videos on planets in the 4th and 10th house. Or you can book a reading with me at ninabastrology.com. Also, if you want to show off how interested in astrology you are, how savvy you are at astrology through the clothing that you wear, you can check out my merch at ninabastrology.com/shop. But that's all from me for today. Hopefully I'll talk to you again very soon. But for now, thank you so much for watching. I hope that you have a great rest of your day or night. Bye.